An ambulance. Great.
Yeah. I've never seen anything like it. This thing is huge. Let's hope we make it. We should have taken people with us to the camp.
I had to be in Dallas with Nathan and Stephanie.
Sorry. Supposed to have that dashboard fixed already? You could keep your license suspended, man.
Yeah.
Holy shit,
what the hell was that?
The area must have been evacuated already, right?
Yeah, they must have been. Did you get in touch with the shelter?
No.
I'm gonna honk the horn when we get closer.
Come on, let's go.
I was 5 when I lost my father. He was a hero in the eyes of many, but to me, just a blurred memory. My mother, Stephanie, tried to be my rock and play the role of a father, too. I'm 33, and she's still trying. I've been married for 5 years. We don't have children yet, but Linda thinks it's time. I need to get it together. I used to be a bartender, then tried working as a warehouse clerk, and even as a machine operator. For most of my life, I've been a slacker. Many would call me a loser, and I wouldn't blame them. My mother keeps trying to change that. In fact, she recently spoke to my father's closest friend, Clint, a man with experience in the trucking industry. I guess she hopes that I'll follow in my father's footsteps and get my life back on track. Or at the very least, back in the driver's seat.
Okay, I'll repeat myself one more time. We're about to spend a couple of months together in this metal box. A small space we'll have to share. It'll be hard at times, so you need to practice patience. We both will. On the plus side, we already know each other.
Yeah, it'll be fine.
And keep in mind that I'll be doing my best to help you, and I expect you to do the same for me. Feel free to ask questions whenever you're unsure of something. And I know that given what happened to your father, trucks are hardly your favorite topic, but this is the job. We can also talk about him if you like.
Yeah, sure.
You and I haven't spoken in years, so sharing this cab will be challenging. On paper, this is my truck, but over the next few weeks, it's gonna be your home as well. Any questions?
For starters, we need to fill up the tank, right?
Straight down to business, eh, attaboy. That's right, we'll fuel up. But first, check the map for the nearest gas station, and then get this beast on the road.
Thank you.
I see that you only have a few small bags. You're the son of a truck driver after all.
Well, my wife helped.
How does she feel about this new venture of yours?
I don't really know. She wants me to have a steady job and pay the bills.
Uh-huh.
I mean, her uncle was a trucker, so I'm pretty sure she knows the drill.
Keeping your family together isn't easy, believe me. But the money's good.
So you'll both need to compromise to find a balance. I'm not a good example of this, but other truckers have managed to not only start a family, but also keep it together.
Why? What happened?
If you weren't Charles' son, I'd probably tell you it's none of your goddamn business. But there'll be plenty of time to talk about it. Just not right now, okay?
Okay.
Ever parked a semi-truck at a gas station before?
Nope.
All right, let's see what you got. Don't worry, I'll help if needed.
Okay.
I think you did great. Now it's set to the depot.
What are we hauling, by the way?
You won't always know exactly what you're transporting. It's rare, but you should keep it in mind. Sometimes the company just tells you to get the cargo from point A to point B, and that's it. But right now, we'll be taking a trailer to a repair shop.
All right. Thank you.